Hi dear friends, dear civil service aspirants. First of all, I wish you all a great day. What is the best strategy for history in prelims 2020? My dear friends, if you really wish to clear prelims 2020, you must have a good strategy for each core subject in this examination. This video will give you a perfect picture about the best strategy of preparing history in the prelims examination, what you must do, what you must not do in these days for scoring well from history in the prelims. So when it comes to history, let's have a look into the prelims examination. Some core subjects in the prelims, definitely history is one of the main pillars of your prelims examination. History, economy, geography, polity, environmental science and current affairs. When you analyze the last 15 years, last 10 years question paper, previous year's question paper, you could notice that all these six subjects are the core subjects: history, economy, geography, polity, environmental science and current affairs, because 85% of questions being asked from these subjects only. So if you thoroughly prepare these subjects with a very good strategy for each, definitely you can easily crack prelims examination. All of you know that there are three phases in our civil service examination. Three phases. First phase, that is prelims examination, paper 1 and paper 2. Paper 2 is CSAT paper. Paper 1, history, economy, geography, polity, environmental science. All the 100 questions comes in paper 1. Then paper 2, CSAT paper. So paper 1, you must have 120. Maximum 120 will be cut off of your paper 1. Then CSAT is a qualifying paper, 33%. That is the qualifying mark from CSAT. So altogether, prelims is a qualifying round. Keep in mind that prelims is preliminary examination is a qualifying round. Then comes mains. In mains, essay, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4 and optional subjects. These are the major areas you have to focus upon in the mains. And finally, interview, which is personality test or personality assessment. So your final result will be decided by the score from your mains examination and the score from your interview. So preliminary examination is a qualifying round, but it is very necessary to qualify prelims, then only you can attempt mains and interview. So qualifying prelims means you are eligible for mains. Qualifying mains means you are eligible for interview, and your final rank will be decided based on your score from mains and interview. So just have a look into this history. In order to understand the proper strategy of history, first of all, you understand what was asked from history, or how the history was asked in the prelims examination in the previous years. Let's have a look from 2011 to 2019. Why I taken from 2011 to 2019? Because this new pattern of prelims. This new pattern of prelims that was introduced in 2011, still it is followed till the last year, 2011 to 2019. So if you check this 2011 to 2019, you could notice that, from modern India, how many questions being asked? 2011, 9 questions, 2012, 12 questions, 2013, 6 questions, 2014, 5, 2015, 9 questions, 2016, 6 questions, 2017, 7 questions, 2018, 13 questions, 2019, 6 questions being asked from modern India. Then ancient India UG, 2011, 3, then 5, 8, 4, 2, 4, 2, 2, 4, 2019, 4 questions asked from ancient India. Then medieval India UC, 2011, nil, no questions from medieval India. 2012, 2 questions. 2013, 1 question. 2014, 3 questions. 2015, 3 questions, 16, 3 questions, 2017, 1 question, 2018, 2 question, and 2019, 6 questions being asked from medieval India. Culture, 1 2011, 2 questions in 2012, 1 in 2013, 9 questions in 2014, then again 3 questions in 2015, then 4 questions in 16, 4 questions in 17, 4 questions in 18, 2 questions in 2019. Okay, so what I am saying is this is the way modern, ancient, medieval and culture. These are the core areas of history which you have to prepare for your prelims examination. And when you see this analysis, you can see that largest number of questions always asked from modern India. Okay, always asked from modern India, then definitely ancient India, then this medieval India and the culture. Culture means ancient related culture, medieval, modern related culture and secular culture, performing visual arts, etc. They ask. So just try to understand how many questions UPSC asked from history in each year. 2011, 13 questions asked from history. 2012, 21 questions asked. 2013, 16 questions asked. 2014, 21 questions asked. 2015, 17 questions asked. 2016, again 17 questions asked. 2017, 14 questions asked. 2018, 21 questions asked. 2019, 18 questions asked. So what I am saying is, yeah, you can always expect something. 18 to 20 questions from history alone. History means ancient India, medieval India, modern India and art and culture. Okay, so these are the core areas you have to focus upon. 18 to 20 questions you can expect from history alone. History, I said it, including ancient, medieval, modern and art and culture. So your score, if 110 or 120 is your cutoff, okay, if this is the cutoff for qualifying prelims examination, something around 32 or 36, 36 to 40 marks. 32 to 40 marks you score from history alone. So that is the weightage of history in the prelims. First of all, you understand what is the weightage of the history and what is the weightage of each portion in the history in the prelims examination. Okay, this understanding is very much important for you. I am showing you some questions here. 2019, they asked some questions. Detailed analysis we have done in some other sessions. So just to see, look into the question. Have a look into the question. Yeah, this is a question from modern India, which is about the constitutional reforms during British India. Constitutional reforms during British India. So if you check this question, you can notice that UPSC started asking analytical questions, conceptual questions or analysis based questions. So my advice to all of you is, don't follow the fact based preparation. Okay, if you are only focusing on by hurting the ears and the names of the kings and dynasties, that will be a wrong strategy. The best strategy is understanding the concept in ancient, medieval and modern. For example, subordinate union, subordinate isolation or doctrine of labs. Okay, or British paramountcy over Indian states. So, or constitutional reforms or about India's freedom struggle. Don't just follow the facts and figures. By hurting the facts and figures, you try to understand the concept. You try to analyze the concepts, the events, the causes, consequences, etc. Okay, so analytical approach is important in the history for clearing or for scoring well from history. Don't follow the facts and figures, memorizing facts and figures. In fact, try to understand the concept. Try to understand the concept, try to analyze the causes, consequences in history. Okay, that is the best strategy for scoring from history, because analysis based questions UPSC asks from history in the prelims examination. So many questions were there. Then ancient India. When you study ancient India, definitely you have to cover the core modules which I tell you. Buddhism, Jainism from ancient India. Then medieval India, Delhi Sultanate, Vijayanagar Empire, Mughal Empire. So many things are there which you have to focus upon. So here, when it comes to ancient India, I must say, UPSC asked you questions from Indus Valley Civilization, Harappan Civilization. They asked you questions from these Vedic culture, Rigvedic and to later Vedic culture. They asked you questions from Buddhism and Jainism. They asked you questions from this Mauryan Empire. They asked you questions from this post-Mauryan era. Post-Mauryan era. They asked you questions from this Gupta age. They asked you questions from this post-Gupta age. So, I will tell you, when you study ancient India, this must be your strategy. You cover these portions from ancient India. Harappan civilization, Vedic culture, religious movements like Buddhism, Jainism, such revolutionary movements in ancient India, Mahajanapadas and Maurya history, post-Maurya history, Gupta and post-Gupta. Okay, so these are the core modules. In fact, you have to study these modules only from this ancient India. Okay, that is the best strategy. And obviously, when you prepare each module, you must also solve the previous year's questions. Solve the previous year's questions, last 10 or 20 years, previous year's question from each module you must solve. So that will further boost your confidence, and also it will definitely give you a picture how UPSC asked you questions from these modules. So many questions and areas are also repeated in the prelims examination. So solving the previous year's questions, that is very, very important as far as scoring is concerned. So see, Indus Valley Civilization, Vedic, Buddhism, Jainism, Mahajanapadas, Mauryas, post-Maurya, Gupta, post-Gupta. It has so many subdivisions also. And UPSC asks questions from NCERT, UPSC asks questions from R. S. Sharma, UPSC asks from this Romila Thapar, or UPSC asks from this old and new edition of NCERT, Tamil Nadu NCERT, etc. So UPSC has a wide like a range of the sources for ancient India. So here, that is why in my course, what I am doing is, with the confidence I am saying, since I am taking this for optional also, that is why I am saying that, all these sources which I have gone through. So our classes and material, they are prepared in such a way that, all these, this will be a single solution for these multiple sources. Okay, so what I am saying is, you don't have that much time for preparation. The best strategy has to be like, in a limited time, very quickly, you have to prepare this ancient India, that is in such a way that all the genuine resources or sources being covered. Okay, one of our strategies is like this. Our material and our classes are done in such a way, these multiple sources are being covered or thoroughly prepared. Okay, so you always go for such a genuine source or such a genuine material where these multiple sources are available in a single session or single course. Okay, so take care, because they asked, this is you can just check the reliability. They asked you questions from NCERT old edition, new edition. They asked you questions from this Tamil Nadu NCERT. They asked you questions from this Romila Thapar. They asked you questions from this R. S. Sharma. So, for this ancient India, wide variety of sources are there, okay? Even Ubendra Singh also, they picked direct questions from these statements from this Ubendra Singh also. So, all these are the core modules from ancient India. You prepare it very well and solve these previous years questions of last 15 or 20 years from each module. Medieval India, North and South history from... So, ancient India means, I must say, ancient India 2500 BC... to something around 750 AD, or I would say 650 AD. Okay, till the middle of that 7th century AD, you have to cover. Or I would say that it is something, I would say you go up to this middle of this 8th century AD. Up to this middle of this 8th century AD. 2500 BC to mid of that 8th century AD. This is what your ancient India. Okay, till that early medieval India, you have to cover. Then coming across this medieval India, you start from the middle of this 8th century AD. Okay, it will go up to this 1757 or at least till the beginning of this 18th century. Okay, till the beginning of 18th century. So 750, 8th century AD to beginning of 18th century AD, that is medieval India. There you have to cover the early history of this north-south India from 8th to 12th century AD, Bhakti Sufi religious movements of India, Delhi Sultanate, Vijayanagara Empire, Bahmani Kingdom, Mughal Empire, European penetration, advancement of or this like arrival of this advent of Europeans. Okay, so these are the modules you have to cover from medieval India. Nothing else. Only these areas you have to focus upon. And in our sessions, in detail, I have discussed each of these module from our exam point of view. Okay, so these are the modules you have to cover well. It's socio-economic, political, cultural history you have to cover well, because such questions are frequently asked by UPSC in the prelims examination. Take care that after studying each module, you must solve the previous year's questions. Modern India, I would say, yeah, your strategy has to be like this. 18th, 19th and 20th centuries and the current century. Okay, 21st century. So 18, 19, 20 and 21st century, you have to cover well. 21st century means current affairs related to history and culture. Okay, so you see this 18, 19, 20 centuries, that is what are the static portion of your modern history. So decline of Mughal Empire, formation of new states, arrival of the British, conquest of the British, then this company rule, governor general, constitutional reforms and company administration. Then these movements, socio-religious reform movements, tribal movements, lower caste movements, then these civil movements, etc. You have to study. Then 1850s own great rebellion, you have to study. Growth of nationalism, Indian National Congress, various phases like a moderate phase, extremist phase, revolutionary phase, Gandhian phase, and finally achievement of the freedom. So many modules and submodules are there. It must be studied in such a way that you must understand the concept and you have to analyze the causes and consequences of these major events or incidents. Okay, that will help you to score from this modern India. And I said it, modern India is the core area, largest number of questions being asked from this modern India. Okay. And our online history course, it is designed in such a way that the entire history, ancient, medieval, modern, art and culture again, I would say that ancient India art and culture, medieval India art and culture, modern India art and culture, and performing and visual arts of modern times, and current affairs related to art and culture, that much you have to cover. Okay, so we have done these things in such a way that in 110 or 120 hours, the entire course and the test and discussions are the entire course is done in our program. Ancient, medieval, modern, art and culture is done in 110 hours, 120 hours including its test and discussion. So the classes are, online classes are provided. Further, the study material, comprehensive and simplified study material along with the previous year's questions provided. And I said it, we cover in our course like different sources, NCERT, Bibhan Chandra, Grover, Plashy to Partition, Arash, Sharma, Sadish Chandra, Upendra Singh, different sources we researched for this history course for the prelims examination. Just because of the reason that UPSC asked different sources for history questions, framing history questions in the prelims. Okay, then in order to make it easily understandable, your flowcharts, diagrams, maps, and thematic presentations, etc., being used in our smart classes, in our PowerPoint presentations, and test like module test and what is called a sectional test and full test are being provided. And another feature of the online course is definitely you can access it anywhere at any time. Okay, so again, I would say that when you do history, please take care that whatever I said it right now, ancient, medieval, modern and art and culture, this has to be your strategy. This has to be your strategy. In the quickest time, very easily and effectively, you have to cover the core modules which I said. And your focus must be based on the pattern of the examination. I have shown you how many questions asked in each year from each area, be it modern India, ancient India, medieval India or art and culture. So try to understand the demand, accordingly you prepare. And these are the modules which I suggested you that will give you a very, that is the best strategy of preparing history. If you take the last 20 or 25 years questions, from these modules only UPSC asked questions so far. Okay, so advantage of history is it is a static subject. So if you prepare well all these modules in a very comprehensive way, definitely you can score these 30 to 40 marks from this history alone. Okay, so this is what I would share with you, and rest of the things which I have done in other sessions, what all these things you have to prepare in the ancient, medieval, modern, in detail I have done in other sessions. So please watch those sessions. Okay.